Amen. Indeed, this is a wonderful day that the Lord has made, that we may be glad in him. Amen. What as we read the word of God from the book of Ezekiel. Ezekiel. Verse 7. The Bible says that 1, 2, 3 go. Let's read together. 1, 2, 3 go. So I prophesied as I was commanded. And as I prophesied, there was a noise and suddenly a rattling, and the bones came together, bone to bone. Verse 8.
Indeed,
as I looked, the sinews and the flesh came upon,
and the skin covered them over.
But there was no breath in them. Verse 9.
Also, he said to me,
prophesy to the breath. Prophesy, son of man, and say to the breath, thus says the Lord, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe on these slain, that they may live. Verse 10. So I prophesied as he commanded me, and breath came into them, and they lived, and stood upon their feet, an exceedingly great army. Verse 11. Then he said to me, son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They indeed say, our bones are dry. Our hope is lost. And we ourselves are cut off. Verse 12. Therefore, prophesy, say to them, thus says the Lord God, behold, oh my people, I'll open your graves and cause you to come out from your graves and bring you into the land of Israel. Verse 13. Then you shall know that I am the Lord when I have opened your graves, oh my people, and brought you up from your graves. Verse 14. I'll put my spirit in you, and you shall live. Tell your neighbor, you shall live.
You shall live.
Tell your neighbor, you shall live.
You shall live.
And I will bless you in your own land. Then you shall know that I, the Lord, I have spoken it and performed it, says the Lord. I have spoken and I have performed it. I have not only spoken, but I have also spoken it, that you shall live again. Amen. You tell your neighbor, you shall live again. You shall live again. You shall live again. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. Amen. You can have your miracle seat in Jesus' mighty name. Give me the book of 1 John. Chapter 3, verse 8. Book of 1 John 3, 8. He who sins is of the devil. For the devil has sinned from the beginning. For this purpose the Son of Man was manifested, that he might destroy the works of who? The works of who? The works of the devil. And we know that the works of the devil, the Bible says that Jesus came that we may have life. And not just life, but life in abundance, right? But we know the enemy comes only to steal, kill, and destroy. After he have stolen, he kills, he destroys. I want us to hear from the word of God shortly about restoration. about what? Restoration. Ama urejesho kamilivu. Total restoration. Total what? Restoration. The Bible says that the Son of Man or the Son of God was manifested that he may destroy the works of the devil. The works of the devil. Tell your neighbor today, whatever you lost, whatever was destroyed in your life, the Lord will give it life in this service. Mwambie Mungu atarejesha uhai katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Hallelujah. Atarejesha nini? Atarejesha nini? Uhai. Atarejesha uhai. Because it is not the work of our God to destroy. It is not the work of God to cause tears to the righteous. It is not the work of God to destroy that which the righteous have. But it is the work of God to restore that which the enemy has stolen. In the book of Ezekiel chapter 13, the Bible speaks about this prophet of God is receiving instruction from God himself. And he's telling him, the other time we were looking at the power of the spoken word. The power of the spoken. The power of the spoken what? Word. And we say that you are what you confess. You are what you confess. Once you have confessed defeat, definitely you are going to be defeated. But once you have confessed victory, the possibility or the probability is very high that you are going to become victorious because you have spoken it. And we looked at scriptures where the Bible is advising us to use our tongues well. So it is, even at the times and season of restoration, you have to speak for something to happen because you know what the enemy has destroyed in your life. Bible says that when God spoke to the prophet, he did not speak by himself. No, he told the prophet, prophet, you are the one with the eyes. You are the one who can see the bones that are dry. And because you have seen, you must speak. Because this is not the way it was before. There was life in Israel. There was life. But now, as you see, what you can see are dry bones. There is no life. The life has been taken away. But as you begin to speak, something is going to happen. As you begin to proclaim and prophesy over the bones, something will happen. There shall be rattlings. The noise will be heard that bones are coming together. The flesh is coming. Hallelujah. And soon, something will happen. The life will be given back. Today, I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ. Any area of your life where the enemy has destroyed your joy, that the enemy has destroyed your capacity, let there be restoration in the name of Jesus. I say, let there be restoration in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So we are saying that Jesus came that we may have life. Give me the same Ezekiel 7, verse 11. Verse 11. I want to show you something. Because you might be asking, what is it that I am being restored of? Bible says, then he said to me, son of man, these bones are the wool house of Israel. They indeed say our bones are dry. Our hope is lost. And we ourselves are cut off. One of the things that I want us to pray today. That the Lord may restore to us is hope. Sema hope. Ambia mwenzako matumaini. Ambia mwenzako matumaini. Hallelujah. People without life are the people without hope. But B nasema, our bones are dry. Our hope is lost. and we ourselves are cut off. In other words, because we have lost up. We cannot say that we have life. You have heard people say that there are people, we call them the living dead. The living dead. You can lose money and still live. You can lose your job and still live. But the moment you lose hope in life, you are a dead man. The moment you lose hope, unapopoteza matumaini, kama manadamu basi, haina haja uendelee na kuishi. Because hope is the one that drives man. Hope is the one that drives ministries. Hope is the one that drives careers. You are expectant of something great to happen out of something. But the moment you are not expectant of change in your life, it means that then you have given up in life. Hallelujah. Kuna watu ambao pengine mlianza kuomba Mungu miaka tano iliyopita, mwaka ukaisha, mwaka wa pili, mwaka wa tatu, ukaona ni kana kwamba Mungu atendi. Hiyo ndiyo kuangamia kwako. Hiyo kuona tuna kuwasa ya kwamba Mungu atendi. That is all. But the moment you keep on believing, the moment you keep on believing, something happens. The Bible says there is hope. Tell your neighbor there is hope. Even when a tree has been cut, it can rise up again. It can do what? It can rise up again. Though a righteous man may fall seven times, he will still stand again. I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ. Hautakata matumaini katika maisha katika jina Yesu Kristo. Hautakata matumaini na popote ama chochote kilichofanyika katika maisha yako kikakukatisha tamaa ya maisha, ninatangaza urejesho. Hallelujah. Let there be restoration. Many times life is not a walk in the park. Many times life, there come mountains, there come hills, there are downfalls. But one of the things that the Lord has promised us that we hold to hold on is up in Him. The psalmist writes and says, though I lift up my eyes unto the mountains, but where does my help come from? My help comes from Elohim. Once you have hope in Him, once you have faith in Him, hallelujah, that brings a turnaround in your life. May the Lord restore you in your place where you have given up in life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. There are people right now, you cannot tell them to do business because something happened in their business and they wakakata tamaa. There are people right now, you cannot tell them go back to school because something happened in their school life. Na wana furaha ya masomo tena. There are people outside there who have given up on coming to church and fellowships because hawana matumaini, and the devil has taken that opportunity to kick them right, left and center because they have given him the legal ground to attack them. May you never lose hope in life in the name of Jesus. I say may you never lose hope in the name of Jesus Christ. Romans chapter 5 verse 5 inasema namna gani? Now hope does not do what? Let's read together. Now, one, two, three, go. Now hope does not disappoint because the love of God has been poured out in our spirit by the Holy Spirit who was given to, To us by the Holy Spirit. The love of God has been poured unto us by by the Holy Spirit.
Who was given unto us? Kwa hivyo kitu moja ambao maandiko haya yanatuonyesha ni kwamba ukiona mtu mwenye kukata tamaa katika mambo ya kiroho, huyo mtu ana Roho Mtakatifu. Ana nini? Ana Roho Mtakatifu. Now hope does not disappoint, because hope does not disappoint. The God that we serve does not disappoint. Our trust in Jesus does not disappoint. Our trust in the Holy Spirit who was given to us does not disappoint. So whenever disappointment comes in a life of a man, it means that that man no longer have the Holy Spirit in them. They don't have the Holy Spirit in them. Amen. One day the Bible says that David akaenda vitani na maadui wakaingia katika kijiji, wakaiba mifugo, wakaiba watoto, wakaiba mali ya majenerali aliyokuwa nayo. Na waliporudi katika hema yao, maandiko inasema wakamuinukia wakamwambia Daudi, wewe ndiye uliyetupeleka wapi kwa vita, kwa hivyo you must provide for us. But the Bible says David did not murmur, David did not complain. He strengthened himself in the Lord. He sought comfort in the Lord. Asubuhi ya leo nimekuja kukuambia kwamba sijui nini ambacho kimekukatiza tamaa katika maisha. Sijui ni nini ambacho kimekukatiza tamaa katika hali ulio, lakini Bwana anasema atakupa urejesho katika matumaini. Anasema atakupa urejesho. Atakurejeshea. Haleluya. Atakurejeshea. Kama ni furaha ya wokovu iliyoibiwa na dhambi, iliyoibiwa na misukosuko ya maisha, Bwana anasema I shall restore unto you the joy of your salvation, that you may have hope in me and hope in life. Hakuna kukata tamaa tena katika jina la Yesu Kristo. And that which has threatened your life, that which has caused you to be disappointed, that which has caused you tears of pain, that which has caused you to give up in life, enough is enough. The Lord will restore you. I say the Lord will restore you. Will restore you. Hautawaza kujua tena. Hautawaza kujiangamiza tena. Hautawaza kuondokea kile ambacho ni chako tena. Because the Lord will strengthen you. I say the Lord will strengthen you. The situation will not bring you down. Rather, it is an experience to make you stronger. Because he says, I know the plans I have for you. The plans to prosper you. The plans to strengthen you. The plans to take you to nation. The plans to give you good health. The plans to make you more than conqueror. Because I am in you. And that which is in you is greater than the one that is in the world. And he who is in us is no other than the power of God. The Holy Spirit. The Elohim. The Yahweh. He gives us strength. Day in, day out. Let that strength be released upon your life. Nasema hiyo nguvu iachiliwe katika maisha yako. Clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus. Hallelujah. Job chapter 14 verse 7. Job 14 verse 7. For there is hope for a tree. If it is cut down, that it will sprout again. That its tender shoot will not cease. Will not do what? Will not do what? Will not cease. Will not cease to grow. The tender shoots. Give us amplified version. For there is hope for a tree. If it is cut down, that it will sprout again. And that the tender a shoot of it will not cease, but there is no such hope for a man. Give us NLT. Even a tree has more hope. Look here. Even what? A tree, if it is cut down, it will sprout again and grow new branches. That in something that is not as important to God as you are, it has hope. That it has comes a time when it is about to sprout again. What about you? That Jehovah gave out his only begotten son to die for you. Jesus did not die for you to live a life of disappointment. Jesus did not die for you to live a reckless life. Jesus did not die for you to live a life of murmuring and struggling. Jesus died for you to live life in hope and abundance. In hope and abundance. So if he can give out his only son for you, and what about a tree that nobody cares about it, but it has hope? You are more than a tree. Tell your neighbor, you are more than a tree. Mwambie wewe ni zaidi ya mti, na mti uko na matumaini. Hallelujah. Mahali maandiko inasema ya kwamba kama yeye analisha ndege za angani ambazo hata zilimi wala kupanda, anajali, anazipa matumaini ya kwamba asubuhi ninapoamka kitu kitafanyika. What about you? Why are you giving up? Why are you giving up? Bow your head for 1 minute. Tell God that, Lord, strengthen me. Strengthen me. Nitie nguvu tena. Nitie nguvu tena. Nitie nguvu tena. Nitie nguvu tena. Habari za kutisha zinatoka mashariki magharibi ambazo zinanifanya nikate tamaa katika maisha. But Lord Jehovah, I call upon your name, for those who call upon your name shall not be put unto shame. That Jehovah strengthen us. Restore your hope. 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 In Jesus' mighty name. Clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus. Shout hallelujah. Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 5. The Lord restore us. Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 5. There is 1, 2, 3, go right. Be together. There is another evil I have seen under the sun. King and rulers make what? A grave mistake. Give us New King James Version as we continue. New King James. Okay, verse 6. Folly is set in great what? Dignity. While the rich sit in a lowly what? Place. 7. I have seen servants on horses, while princes walk on the ground like servants. One of the things that I pray that we may not lose this year and this season is what we call loss of identity. Loss what? Loss of identity. Loss of identity. I have seen servants on horses, while princes walk on the ground like servants. Bible says that, don't you know that you are gods? But because of lack of that revelation and that understanding, Bible also tells us that you shall die like a mere man. Like a mere man. Because we don't understand who we are. Loss of identity. That Lord will restore us this season and this year. Our identity in him. Our identity in him. Hallelujah. This is a servant. This is a princess. But when you look at their life is something else. Whoever has taken your position, because of your ignorance, today we declare by the word of God, Bible says that my people perish for lack of knowledge. Today may you receive knowledge. I say may you receive knowledge to transform your life. May you receive knowledge to give you a upper hand over the enemy, to give you a higher platform up above your enemies. Because knowledge is power. Knowledge is what? Is power. You cannot go beyond your revelation. Tell your neighbor, you resemble your revelation. Or the level of your revelation. Hallelujah. Uwe sihishi maisha, juu ya vile ambavyo uko na ufunuo ya maisha. Vile ulivyo sasa, hata ukiwa hauna matumaini ama uko na matumaini, kuna level ya revelation ya maisha ukiwa nayo utaishi hiyo kiwango. Amen. Somebody say that there is something that the rich knows that the poor do not know. That makes the difference. That makes what? That makes what? The difference. We call experts to advise us on matters of expertise where we need them because there is knowledge that they have that we don't have. We call doctors to come and treat us because there is a knowledge that they have that we do not have. So that knowledge gives them upper hand. Right now, because doctors are on strike, everyone is complaining. True or false? Everyone is complaining. We are praying. We are enforcing, saying that, Lord, soften the hearts of doctors. But they are saying, no, what we know, you don't know. So pay us well, because there's something that we know that you don't know. Hello? That a minister with a mere certificate of a college cannot dictate my salary because there is something that I know. I have gone beyond 6 years somewhere. So when I say I need 300, let that be 300,000. Hello? And at the end of the day, something will be given to them because there is something that they know that we don't know. Amen. Kama ungejua kutibu, kama daktari hapo, unaenda unani one on one here, my boy, right? So you can advise me on a few things. But kwa sababu sina hiyo knowledge, sitakuja mikono mitupu. Nitakuja na kitu, nipokee. So daktari ambaye akona lack of knowledge ya who he or she is, atatumika vibaya. Are we together? Atatumika vibaya. Mkristo ambaye aelewi the power that has been bestowed in him through Christ, atatumika vibaya na mapepo. There are things that will not be able to control them. Amen. But the moment umepata ufunuo ya kwamba wewe ni nani, that revelation will make you walk kifua mbele, because there is something that you know that people don't know. May the Lord give you wisdom in the name of Jesus. I say this year, you'll not lose your identity in the name of Jesus Christ. You'll not lose your identity in the name of Jesus Christ. He created man and told them, go and dominate. Go and dominate. Go and dominate. We are here on this earth to dominate. That's why I refuse to live life like another man. To live life like another creature. I must live life as the Christ has directed me to live. May that be your portion in the name of Jesus. May that be portion in the name of Jesus Christ. Luke 15:14. Are we flowing? Ebuliza mwenzako, wewe unajielewa kweli? Muliza wewe unajielewa kweli? Luke 15:14 nasema nini? But when he had spent all, there arose a severe famine in that land, and he began to be in want. 15. Then he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into his field to feed swine. 16. And he would gladly have filled his stomach with the pods that the swine ate, and no one gave him anything. 17. But when he came to himself, when he came to who? To himself. He said, how many of my father's hired servants have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger? This is a story of the prodigal son. We call him prodigal son. The Bible calls him the prodigal what? The prodigal son. I don't have problem with this man asking for his inheritance, but I have problem on how he uses whatever he receives from the father. That is where the problem is. He has gone to the father because he has understood his identity as an heir in that family, that I have the right to inherit from my father. Whatever is it, my father is for me. Because the Bible says heirs are just like servants when they are in their, they have not reached the age to inherit from their parents. But the moment they reach the age that they are able now to inherit from their fathers, now the right to inherit becomes real to them. So this man got an understanding that I am in my father's house, and in my father's house there is my portion. So daddy, give me my portion. But the problem is how he used it. He squanders whatever he received from the father. All of a sudden the Bible says he came back to his senses. In other words, he realized his identity. Once you have lost your identity as a child of God, sickness, diseases, oppressions from demons will oppress you from right, left, and center. They will oppress you. They will bring you down. Everything that you touch, they will destroy, because you have lost your identity until you come back to your senses. When you come back to your senses and realize who you are in Christ, then you arise by that knowledge and you are able to rebuke the enemy. Until you come back to your senses to understand who you are, tell your neighbor, I am whom the Lord says I am. They don't believe. Talk to another neighbor, tell them, I am whom the Lord says I am. He came back to his senses. This day, somebody must come back to his or herself. You must come back to yourself. Hallelujah. You must come back to yourself. You know yourself. You know whom the Lord says you are. You know, the Bible says, he says that I cannot perish with hunger, lest yet in my father's house, servants, not sons, servants, hired servants, they have enough bread. How comes that servants are enjoying life, yet the son of the family is perishing out of anger? This is why, this is the knowledge that children of God of this season and this dispensation, they are unable to understand. That's why when you go to the marketplace, people who are dominating in business, people who are dominating in careers, are harvest, are devil worship, our people are Satanist, because we are afraid to understand whom we are. Whom we are. We are afraid to understand. we have failed to understand. Hallelujah. We have failed to understand who we are in Christ. We have lost our identity. That's why a drunkard from nowhere will begin a company today and tomorrow he becomes a multi-billionaire. Yet we still say that gold and silver belongs to God. You call yourself a son of God, daughter of Zion, daughter of Christ. Yet whatever is due to you has been taken by another man. In all offices, 90% of offices where we work, Christians are the people who complain more than the rest. Hallelujah. 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 Utapata tu, kimtu tu from nowhere, is being promoted. Yet you have the same qualification. But because you are yet to come to your senses, when you come to your senses, you understand that the Bible says, ask, and shall be given. Knock, and shall be opened. Seek, and it shall be found. So, when you have lost your identity, you don't have the knowledge to seek. When you have lost your identity, you don't have the knowledge to knock. When you have lost your identity, you don't have the knowledge to seek. But the moment you come back to your senses, you are able to seek. You are able to seek. You are able to knock. You are able to find. And when you seek, you find. Because God is not a man that he may lie. God is not a man that he may lie. Who has he has spoken a thing and it must come to pass. It is our God. It is our, it is what? It is what? Our God. Raise up your hand and shout, my Father, my Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, as a princess, as a prince in the kingdom of God, I refuse to walk on foot while servants are seated on horses. Clap your hands for Jesus. Something has been built along Kangundo Road there. We call it, I don't know, Piva or whatever. When you pass that place from Monday to Monday, magari zimepakiwa hapo. Matthew. Netukiva. Magari. Sinakaa namna gani? Let's look outside the church. Let's look. And those people, they were once born again. Those people. Most of them, 99%, they were once born again. But when they received, when they did what? When they received, it is until they lose it when they will come into their senses. But before they can come to their senses, you also ought to come to your senses to claim that which is yours. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Mtu wa majini atapewa mali na waganga na mimi mungu wangu akose kunipea. Raise up your hand and shout, my Father, my Father. I cannot die poor. Because you are the owner of gold and silver. Amen. Most of them, hata ile kazi unafanya, umewashinda. But because there's something they know that you don't know. There's something they know about their God that you don't know about your God. Hello. Akiambiwa atoe mtoto, atatoa. Kwa hiyo ukiambiwa saa hii utoe 10,000, utatoa. Usitoe mtoto 10,000, utatoa. Niseme saa hii, God is directing me to call 10 people to give 100,000 each. Stand on your feet. Will you stand? Hallelujah. But those people, when they are told that, sir, this man you are competing with, he goes to Revival and Restoration Deliverance Church. That church is powerful. Unless you give your son, You cannot arise to that level, managerial level. You cannot rise to that. They will say, oh, is that so? They give. Then all of a sudden tomorrow, you had been promised to be promoted. Something happens. And instead of being promoted, you are fired. And somebody who gave their son at night is promoted. Wickedness under the sun. Evil under the sun. Where the prince is walking on foot and the servant is riding on horse. Shout, my father, oh Lord, as I begin to pray, restore my identity in Christ, the identity of walking in victory, the identity of living life as a son of the King, of living life as a son of the Most High God, a victory, victorious life, because that is my portion. That is my portion. That is my portion. That whatever kills people in my family can never kill me, because I am not on that tribe. I am not of that family. I am on the tribe of Judah. Hallelujah. Losing your identity. You become a casualty when you lose your identity. When you lose your identity, you suffer. Hallelujah. 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 Hii Mungu atusaidie sana. Hii Mungu atusaidie sana. People who are yelling and saying that the church of today does not manifest power. The church of today does not do this and this. But that is not the problem. Because God does not change. He is the same yesterday. He is the same today. He is the same tomorrow and forevermore. God who used Catherine Kuhlman is the God who can use you. But the problem is, there is something that those guys knew about God that we don't know. We don't know. Amen. We don't know. There is something. There is something about the secret place. There is something that because of their identity in Christ, because their identity was not stolen, there is something they knew that we don't know. But I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that this identity restoration, as it is being restored unto us, that knowledge will be manifested in our lives. I say that knowledge will be manifested in our lives. And as from today, we are not going to live life like any other person. We are going to live life as the chosen of the people. Don't you know that you are a chosen generation, peculiar people, that the Lord has called you, that the Lord has ordained you, that the Lord has blessed you in high place. Bible says that the Lord Jesus has resurrected and he is seated high above on the right hand of the Father. And we as believers, we are seated with him in high place. If I am seated with Christ, why is it that diseases are oppressing me? If I am seated with Christ, why is it that the enemy is defeating me? When I am seated with Christ, it means that something is not right. It means that my knowledge has a problem. It means that my identity has been stolen. It is high time I stop speaking things, but I believe in them. I have hope in them that if Lord is seated there where powers and principalities have been defeated, then nothing under the sun is supposed to defeat me. Nothing under the sun that is supposed to scare me off. Nothing under the sun that is supposed to abort my destiny. Nothing under the sun that is supposed to abort that which the Lord has given to me. He said on the cross that it is finished. When he says it is finished, it is finished indeed. When he says it is over, it is over indeed. What is it that he's saying it is over? Oppression is over. Somebody clap your hands and declare, today I must receive back what belongs to me. Somebody pray that prayer, that today what belongs to me, I receive it back. I receive it back by revelation, by the word of God. I bless the man. Atikatalabashera, suprikete liakata, itolia kato, zekedegedia, zagadagada. My lost identity must be restored. Must be restored. As a child of God, I must be restored. My business must be restored. My career must be restored. Whatever they stole for my destiny, for my life, I bless the man in the name of Jesus. Let it be loose. Let it be loose. Let it be loose. Let it be loose. Whatever they took out of my life, I bless the man on the heavens that Jehovah, a mercy, I restore us. A mercy, I restore us. Ikata kata, zebia kato, iprikote libasia kata, atata labasia, kuprikete libasia, izandia kata, esopila kata, izagadagadia, zolia katala, zegedegedia, asoprikete, zalikata libasia, asopalikatata, izelia kato, asoprikete, whatever was stolen from this ministry, through our ignorance, whatever was stolen from our families, through our ignorance, we bless the man. Let there be restoration. Let there be restoration. Let there be restoration. We correct the error. The error. We correct that error. Whatever occurred during our path, whatever occurred during our rising up, that has disadvantaged. We bless the man. We bless the man. We bless the man. I declare, let there be restoration. Let there be restoration. Let there be restoration. Let there be restoration. Clap your hands as you continue to pray. Push, push, push. Continue to declare. It must be restored. It must be restored. It must be restored. Let my identity in Christ be restored. Continue to push. Declare. Continue to live below my standards just because my identity was stolen by the devil. I cannot continue to live below my standard because wicked men and women have stolen my identity. I cannot continue to live below my standard just because witches and wizards of the village, of the city, have taken away my identity. I cannot continue to survive in the city because somebody somewhere is manipulating my identity. I rise and I bless the man in the realm of the spirit. I contend for that which is mine. I contend for that which belongs to this ministry, for that which belongs to our families, to our children. Our identity in Christ, let it be manifested. Let it be manifested. Let it be manifested. The Bible says, up to now, you have not received because you have not asked. When you ask, when you shall arise and ask, it shall be given unto you. This is the time. I ask a life of victory. I ask a life of dominion. I ask a life of preservation. I ask a life. Ikatopila gata, zelegedia gata, iprikotoliba sela, zakata gada gada, zegedegede, zegedegede, zalia katopa, leko prikede, asulia gata, iparato priketa. Someone declare that any principality, any power of the enemy that has manipulated my identity, that has manipulated, We subdue you by the blood of Jesus. We subdue you by the blood of Jesus. We subdue you by the blood of Jesus. Once an identity has been stolen or destroyed, you are, the probability of you moving to the wrong direction is very high. So pray that, Lord, by my identity, I shall walk toward my blessings. By my identity in you, Christ Jesus, I shall walk towards freedom, deliverance, and liberty. For whom the Son has set free is free indeed. Family foundation that has corrupted my identity, family outers that has corrupted my identity, in the name of Jesus, hear the voice of the Lord, that today enough is enough. You must lose me. 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 Curses of the hair, curses of the land, curses of the sea that were pronounced by men in authority and out of authority to manipulate our identity, in the name of Jesus Christ, we arise, not by mighty, neither by power, but by the Spirit of God. We arise, we arise, we arise by the blood of Jesus Christ, the blood that speaketh good things, than the blood of Abel, the blood that counsels condemnation, the blood that speaks life, the blood that speaks victory, the blood that speaks restoration, in the name of Jesus. Tonight is my day. This is my day. This is my time. My time has come. Our time is a church. Our time has come. Iswali akata kata, zebige diakata, asola bagadiaga, I kata kata kata, leta kata kata, zopaliko priketa, I totoli masia kata, aa kata kata kata, zopalia kata, aidalishi. Walitumia nini? Aidalishi. Walitumia nguvu za aina gani? Waliotumia uchawi, waliotumia majini, waliotumia ekatakatia kata, kwa jina la Yesu. We overturn their power. We overturn their powers. We overturn their powers. We overturn their powers. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Walioachilia mishale usiku wa mchana, waliotuma ndege usiku, waliachilia kasopia kata, izolia kata, mishale katika hanga, waliachilia to manipulate our identity, ikata kata kata, zelia katola mashela, zopala kata kata, zegedegede, ikutolia kata, zalipakia kato, brikete libasia kata, zalabagadia kata. Once, oh Lord, have you spoken? Twice have we heard that power belongs to you. Power to deliver us. Power to heal us. Power to secure our destiny. Power to secure the lives of our children. Power to secure our careers belongs to you. When God is on our side, no man, no witch, no sorcerer can be against us. Therefore, any man who is against our rising up, any woman who is against our rising up as a family, as a ministry, as a career, kashakate malia, zoprikete, itatatata, salepo kopikete. We deploy angels of warfare. We deploy angels of warfare. Kayakata, izeliakata, ipaliko priketa, zalagadagara, wherever our identity was buried, we are here, ikatagada, nachilia msako, tunachilia msako, katika anga ya tasia, katika anga ya tasia, nachilia msako, katika anga ya Nairobi, nachilia msako, katika anga ya vijijini na mjini, ya kwamba, ikatagada, len, our identity be loose, be loose, be loose, be loose. Somebody declare. Pray, pray. until they lose you, until they lose you. The living for his glory, for his glory, for his glory, for his glory. The Lord say that we dominate. Someone declare any area of my life where the Lord has ordained me to dominate and take control, and the enemy has manipulated it. I place demands and I declare. Of life you are living today, it is not your life, it's not your life. Your identity has been stolen. So pray that, Lord, restore me to my place, restore me to my place, restore me to my place. Restore me to my place. Declare that, Lord. Restore me to my place. Oh, shut up. Raise up your hands and shout, my Father, my Father. You are not shouting. I want you to shout, my Father, my Father. That is not shouting. You are just speaking. You are just murmuring. Shout power. My Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
As I begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
Let my identity.
Let my identity.
In Christ Jesus.
In Christ Jesus.
Be restored.
Be restored.
Any kind of life.
Any kind of life.
That I am living today.
That I am living today.
As a result. Of manipulated identity.
Of manipulated identity.
Oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
As I begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
Let the error be corrected.
Let the error be corrected.
And let your power.
And let your power.
Bless me.
Bless me.
To the right place.
To the right place.
Clap your hands and begin to fire that prayer. Fire that prayer. Pray 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 that prayer. Refuse to settle for less. You refuse to settle for less. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I say? Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
This is something that you can assess yourself. You can assess yourself. You know that. At the beginning, it was not like this. This is an error that has just occurred along the way. In the beginning, it was not like this. But there was an error that occurred on the way that displaced me from my right place. I want us to believe God together for restoration. I want us to believe God together for restoration. So before we can enter to the second service, you are saying that in the beginning, it was not like this. But something has happened on the way. I have been displaced. I can feel it in the spirit that this was not my level. My level is supposed to be higher than this. Rush to the altar. Let us pray together. Let's believe God together. You have 1 minute. We pray together before we can get into the second service. You are saying that you can feel it. That something happened. Something happened. This is not my life. This is not my life. Something happened. And my identity was manipulated. We have less than 30 seconds. My identity was manipulated. Was manipulated. How comes I was that genius in school, but all of a sudden I cannot comprehend it? How comes that I was doing this and this, and I was getting this kind of margin of profit, but nowadays nothing is coming out of it? What happened? Who is it that manipulated my destiny? Who is it that manipulating my identity? Once you have come here forward, just open your mouth and begin to plead for mercy. And Jehovah, there is a place you had blessed me before. Restore me to that place. Restore me. There is a place you had elevated me to. I don't know what happened, my Father, but have mercy on me and restore my identity in you. You have not created me to be a failure. You have not created me to be defeated in life. You created me to be victorious. Jehovah, hata wewe uliapo, inua mikono yako and close your eyes. Everyone raise up your hands and close your eyes. Our identity. We say that the powerful evangelists are not the one in the church. Some of them, their identity has been manipulated. They are working in bars. They are doing fishy things somewhere. I want you to plead God that God have mercy and restore my identity. Restore my identity. Whatever was stolen, whatever has been manipulated by my family foundation, whatever was manipulated through association, because people are not just people, people are outers. There are people you associate with and you begin to go down. There are people you do business with and you begin to go down. Why? Because they have mastered the power to manipulate other people's identity. They cannot reduce you to beggar. They cannot reduce you to become a beggar while you are a son or a daughter of this ministry. I join hands with my Father in the Lord, and the grace of God operating in this altar, and I declare anyone under my voice whose identity has been manipulated, either by family foundation, either by association, by friends, by family, we declare, let them be loose, let them be delivered. I declare, let your deliverance come in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, I restore your identity in Christ. Whatever was stolen from you, any error that occurred in my life before, by the mercies of God, let the error be corrected. I say, let the error be corrected. In the name of Jesus Christ, Son of the Living God, Jehovah, the identity that was stolen from your daughters, by your mercies, by your grace, let there be restoration. Let there be restoration. Chochote ambacho ni chako, ambacho kwa katika mikono ya ndugu, let it be loosed. Let it be loosed. Let it be loosed. I say, let it be loosed. Lord, by your mercies, let it be loosed. As from today, let there be songs of joy, songs of celebration, that you have done them well. In Jesus' mighty name, Father, we declare, and let your word that you have spoken today be established up high in heavens. Let men be liars, but let you, God, be true, that it shall come to pass what you have spoken to us through your Spirit. We have faith in your word. We have faith in you. We have faith in your servants. Establish us. Receive all and all the glory this morning as we continue, Lord. We pray that your power may continue to position us to our right place. Place of victory. Place of dominion. We thank you and worship you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Somebody shout a good amen. Clap your hands for Jesus. Clap your hands for Jesus. Celebrate Jesus. I say, celebrate Jesus. Celebrate King of Kings. Celebrate King of Kings. Celebrate King of Kings. So faithful, so faithful, so faithful, you are so faithful, so faithful, so faithful, you are.